known from the first part of the story that how Becky was eager to see the doll which was gifted to Sara on her birthday, and how Sara helped by requesting Miss Minchin to allow Becky to stay. Miss Minchin waved her hand towards the door. Miss Minchin waved her hands means towards the door, pointed her hand towards the door. Go and stand there. She commanded that go and stand there. She commanded not to near the young ladies. She will not. She also instructed that she should not stand near the young ladies. Becky went to her place grinning. She did not care where she was sent. Now Becky was happy that wherever she would stay, she would be able to look at the blue box. That was her interest only. And she was not at all interested to stay near the ladies or go away from the ladies. So she was very happy. So she just took her position. She was laughing and she was happy and she did not care where she was sent. Now young ladies, I have a few words to you say to you, announced Miss Minchin. Now at that time, Miss Minchin declared that she had something to say to the ladies and she is going to make a speech, whispered one of the girls. I wish it was over. She whispered that she was about to make a she was about to give a speech. The girls were not at all eager to listen to the speech of Miss Minchin. And they said what? They were wishing eagerly that it should be getting over. Sara felt rather uncomfortable. As it was her party, it was probable the speech was about her. Now, Sara felt uncomfortable because Sara did not want any publicity or she did not want to be the center of the attraction. She was just doing her duty and she was just enjoying with the other girls only. And she felt uncomfortable because she knew that it was her party and Mrs. Minchin probably Mrs. Minchin would be speaking in favor of Sara only. You are aware, young ladies, the speech began, that dear Sara is 11 years old today. Several of you have also been 11 years old. But Sara's birthdays were rather different from other little girls' birthdays. When she is older, she will be heiress to a large fortune, which it will be her duty to spend in a meritorious manner. Now the speech began. At first, what Miss Minchin said that everyone must be conscious about young ladies, that dear Sara, means that Sara was becoming 11 years old that day, and several little girls would have birthdays on the same day, but their birthdays were not at all similar to that of Sara's. Sara's birthday was quite different. Why? Because Sara would become an heiress. Heiress means a very wealthy lady who is the successor of a large fortune. Okay, so he would become a very wealthy lady. And it would be her duty to spend everything in a very rather meritorious, in a very clever manner. The diamond mines, giggled Jessie in a whisper. So Jessie knew that Sara's father was the owner of the diamond mine. Now Jessie laughed and said that Sara would be the owner of the diamond mines. Sara did not hear her, but as she stood with her grey green eyes fixed on Miss Minchin, she felt herself growing rather warm. So Sara was not at all consciously hear Miss Minchin, but as she stood in with her grey green eyes fixed on Miss Minchin, means her grey green eyes, her eyes were grey green, and she stood with her grey green eyes fixed on Miss Minchin. She was standing there fixing her eyes on Miss Minchin, and she felt herself growing rather hot, and she felt very uncomfortable. She becoming angry. When Miss Minchin talked about money, she felt somehow that she always hated her. When Miss Minchin was talking about money, she felt that money. Somehow that he always hated her. And of course it was disrespect to hate people. Now, due to Miss Minchin's character, Miss Minchin was very eager about money. Miss Minchin was very much favoring whom? Sara, for her money. Miss Minchin was looking down upon all girls because they were not as rich as Sara. These thoughts really disturbed Sara very much. And she felt rather angry when Miss Minchin started speaking about her. And of course, she knew that she should not hate grown-up people. But whenever she considered Miss Minchin talking about money, talking about status, talking about position, she had a type of hatred for Miss Minchin. When her dear papa, Captain Crewe, brought her from India and gave her into my care, the speech proceeded. He said to me in a jesting way, I am afraid she will be very rich, Miss Minchin. My reply was, her education at my seminary, Captain Crewe, shall be such as will adorn the largest fortune. So Captain Crewe was the merchant who brought her from India and gave her to give her into Miss Minchin's care. Now, what happened when her dear papa, means when Sara's papa, Captain Crewe, brought her to Miss Minchin's seminary, he said in a very jesting way, means in a mocking tone, he said that what? That he would be, means Sara would be a very rich lady when she would complete her education. And Miss Minchin also assured him that her education at the seminary, a Captain Crewe, would be as she would adorn the largest fortune. Means she would be educated in such a way that she would be a completely established lady, and she would be able to get the fortune. And she would be an heiress, means she would be capable of taking care of the largest fortune. So Miss Minchin would be taking the responsibility, and she would educate Sara in such a way that she would get the fortune. Sara has become my most accomplished people. Her French and her dancing are a credit to the seminary. Her manners, which have caused you to call her Princess Sara, are perfect. So she pointed out that Sara was very perfect in speaking French, and she was a very great dancer. She had become an established pupil, established student of the seminary, and her manners were so polite, her manners were so beautiful that everyone called her little princess. So her amiability she expects giving you this afternoon's party. And how she was very friendly, how she was very pleasant could be seen from the fact that she was giving one afternoon's party in favor of all others. I wish you to express your appreciation of her generosity by saying aloud all together, "Thank you, sir." Then she told everyone that everyone should express their gratefulness that Sara had offered a party on her birthday. And Sara was the most accomplished, means Sara was the most good, and Sara was the most intelligent, Sara was the most appreciable student of the seminary. And everyone must express their gratefulness to Sara. The entire schoolroom rose to his feet. So entire schoolroom stood to its feet, and "Thank you, Sara," it said. Sara looked rather shy for a moment. She made a curtsy. So everyone expressed her gratefulness to Sara, but Sara was feeling rather shy. Means she was not very eager to express. Means receive the response of the gratefulness. She became a little bit shy, and she made a curtsy. Means she just bowed and accepted all students. She accepted all students' great expression of thanks.